Reddy Academy, a unit of Triveni Study Circle.
Hello everyone, welcome to CN Reddy Online Classes. This is Priyanka, Faculty of GK, Current Affairs, Science and Technology and Environmental Issues. Today, we are going to discuss a major topic and an important topic known as Biosphere Reserves. Why I have chosen this topic? Because recently, one of the biosphere reserve in India has been added in a network called as World Network of Biosphere Reserves by UNESCO. So that is the reason we have chosen this topic today. And also, biosphere reserves is an important topic if you take in many subjects like geography, like environment, like GK, like current affairs. It is an important topic. So that is why I have chosen biosphere reserves as an important topic today and as our topic today. Right. So if you see, these are the number of biosphere reserves we have in India. The total number is 18. So 18 are the number of biosphere reserves till date we have established in India by government of India. Right. So these are the biosphere reserves we have. So we have to discuss in detail about all this. And I have said a name called as UNESCO. So first we will discuss about UNESCO. So what is UNESCO? What is UNESCO? UNESCO is an UN specialized agency. Yes or no? Right. UNESCO is a UN specialized agency. So the abbreviation of UNESCO is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization is the full form or the abbreviation of UNESCO. So what is it doing? Every year, UNESCO is going to release some reports. And among that, one of the important report is WNBR. WNBR. So what is it? World Network of Biosphere Reserves. World Network of Biosphere Reserves is its report. Right. So this report is being under a program. This report is being under a program called as Man and the Biosphere. What is it? Man and the Biosphere. So what is this program? It is very confusing, right? So UNESCO has launched a program in the year 1971. The name of the program is Man and the Biosphere. Man and the Biosphere. So what is this program? This program is aiming, or it aims specifically to improve the balance between the man and the environment. It is trying to improve the relationship. Between the man and the environment. So under this program, World Network of Biosphere Reserves is a report released every year internationally. So every year internationally means every year any biosphere reserve in any country, it is going to identify and it is going to include in this area. Okay, in this report. So how many are there till date? Four and next 12. So complete 12. So what I have said, how many number of biosphere reserves are there in India? We have 18 number of biosphere reserves in India, right? So 18 number of biosphere reserves we have, and among that 12 biosphere reserves have been included in that report. So what are the biosphere reserves? How many biosphere reserves and where they are located is our main topic today. Right. First biosphere reserve. So first biosphere reserve is Nilgiri. What is it? Nilgiri. So established in the year 1986, and where it is located in the borders of Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala. So Nilgiri mountain ranges, you already know that where it is located, in the Western Ghats, right? In the Western Ghats. So where is the exact location? Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala. So next one, if you take Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve, where it is? In Uttarakhand, and the year of establishment is 1988. Then next is Nokrek. So in the year 1988, it is located in Meghalaya. Then next is the Great Nicobar in the year 1989, located in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Next is Gulf of Mannar. Gulf of Mannar in the year 1989, located in the state Tamil Nadu. Located in Tamil Nadu. Next is Manas. In the year 1989, where it is located in Assam. So in the name of Manas, we have a national park too in that particular area called Assam. Right. Then next is Sundarban, Sundarban Forest. So where it is located, Sundarban Forest in West Bengal. So established year is 1989. And next is Simlipal. Simlipal in the year 1994, where it is located? Odisha. Where it is located? Odisha. Then next is Dibru-Saikova. So name is little bit difficult, but try to remember Dibru-Saikova in the year 1997, located in Assam. Located in Assam. And next is 10th, Dihang Dibang. Dihang Dibang, where it is located in Arunachal Pradesh. It is located in Arunachal Pradesh. Then next is Pachmarhi. Pachmarhi, where it is located in Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh. Next is Kanchenjunga. Next is Kanchenjunga. You already know that there is a mountain peak called as Kanchenjunga, where it is located in Sikkim. In Sikkim. Then next is Agasthyamalai. Agasthyamalai, located in the borders of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Located in the borders of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Next is Achanakmar Amarkantak. Achanakmar Amarkantak, where it is located in the borders of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. In the borders of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Next is Kutch. Okay, Ran of Kutch, you know, right? Where it is located? Gujarat. Where it is? Gujarat. Then next is Cold Desert. Where it is located? Himachal Pradesh. Right, Himachal Pradesh, the coldest area. Himachal Pradesh. Then next is Seshachalam Hills. Seshachalam Hills, where it is located in Andhra Pradesh, in Chittor, YSR Kadapa district. Right, so there Seshachalam Hills is been located as a biosphere reserve. The last and final one, which is very important, and that is the reason we are discussing now, is Panna. What is it? Panna. Panna is a biosphere reserve located in Madhya Pradesh, and the established year also you have to remember 2011, August 25. 2011, August 25. Why I am saying that date also remember? Because it is the last and final one. That is the last biosphere reserve in India, and also the last biosphere reserve identified by UNESCO till date. Okay, till date. That is the reason you need to remember that exact year and exact date also, right? 2011, August 25. So if you ask me, my best suggestion is that, you know, you have to remember all the biosphere names, all the biosphere reserve names, and along with the location of the biospheres, along with the location of the biospheres. And if you ask me about the years, my best suggestion is please try to remember the last 3 years, the last 3 years of the biosphere reserves, when they have been established, the last three, and also you have to remember the first 3 years, the first three biosphere reserves, when they have been established. So that would be very easier for you for elimination process. And my suggestion is please try to remember all the names of the biospheres and all the locations of the biosphere reserves. So yeah, after completion of this, let's go to the biosphere reserves which have been identified by UNESCO and have been included in World Network of Biosphere Reserves. So out of 18 biosphere reserves in India, 12 biosphere reserves have been included in World Network of Biosphere Reserves. So here also, my suggestion is, please try to remember all the names and all the locations, and exactly when it comes to year, please remember the first 3 years and the last 3 years. Here also, please try to remember the first three and the last three, especially the last two, because there is no much difference. If you see, it is 2018 and it is 2020. So please try to remember. So let's have a quick look on this. First is Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. So this recognized year is 2000. Recognized year is 2000. Where it is located? Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala, as we have already discussed. Then next is Sundarbans in the year 2001 in West Bengal. Sundarbans in the year 2001 in West Bengal. Then next is Gulf of Mannar. Gulf of Mannar in the year 2001 in Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu. And here next is Nanda Devi. Nanda Devi in 2004 in Uttarakhand. 2004 in Uttarakhand. Next is Nokrek. Nokrek, where it is? In Meghalaya in the year 2009. Then Pachmarhi, Madhya Pradesh. Simlipal, where it is? Odisha. Achanakmar Amarkantak, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Great Nicobar, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Agastyamalai, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Kanchanjanga, Sikkim. The last and final one, I mean till date, that is the 12th one, that is Panna Biosphere Reserve in Madhya Pradesh. Year is very, very important.
2020, October 28. 2020, October 28.
Please try to remember the year, the exact location of the Biosphere Reserve and the name of the Biosphere Reserve. Panna Biosphere Reserve in the year 2020, that is the date October 28. So please try to remember these 2 years also. 2016 Agastyamalai, 2018 Kanchanjanga. Please try to remember the years, the last 3 years. So when we comparatively study, both of this. So first biosphere reserve which is being established by Government of India is Nilagiri. First biosphere reserve is Nilagiri, year 1986, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, remember that. And here the first biosphere reserve, the first biosphere reserve identified and added in the World Network of Biosphere Reserve is Nilagiri. So first biosphere which is established is also Nilagiri, and the first biosphere reserve by UNESCO added in WNBR is also Nilagiri. That you have to remember. Then the last one, that is 18th biosphere reserve in India is Panna. 18th biosphere reserve is Panna, 2011 August 25, and the 12th biosphere reserve is Panna, October 28, 2020. So you have to make a difference and make a comparative study so that it will be very, very easier for you to remember. The first Nilagiri reserve is the first reserve identified Nilagiri, the last reserve is Panna, the last identified reserve is Panna. There the number 1, here the number 1, there the number 18, and here the number 12, here the number 12. So if you see, from 18 number biosphere reserves, 12 number are identified. 12 number of biosphere reserves are identified. Then what are the remaining 6? So if the question is identify the biosphere reserve which have been not included in World Network of Biosphere Reserve Program or Man and Biosphere Program, which have not been identified. So that also we have to make a note. So if you ask me, we'll start making note of it. First is Manas, okay, this is the biosphere reserve not been included. Then Dibru-Saikova, second one, Dibru-Saikova. Then next is Dihang Dibang, Arunachal Pradesh, third one, third biosphere reserve. Then fourth is Kutch, Gujarat, fourth one. Fifth, Cold Desert, Himachal Pradesh, the fifth one. And sixth is Seshachalam Hills, YSR, Kadapa. These are the biosphere reserves which have not been included yet in the program, or which have not been identified or not been included in World Network of Biosphere Reserve report. So these are the biosphere reserves. So lastly, we will try to locate the biosphere reserves in map. So right, in the map if you see, we will go from north to south. We will go from north to south. So first one is Cold Desert. Where it is? Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh. Second is Nanda Devi, located in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand. Next is Kanchanjanga, Sikkim. Right. Next, Manas and Dibru-Saikova. Both of them are in Assam. Here, Dihang Dibang, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. Then in Meghalaya, we have Nokrek. Meghalaya, Nokrek. Sundarbans, West Bengal. And in Simlipal, where it is? Odisha. Then here Achanakmar Amarkantak, Panna Pachmarhi. Achanakmar Amarkantak, Panna Pachmarhi. Where it is located? Madhya Pradesh. Where it is located? Madhya Pradesh. Next is Seshachalam Biosphere Reserve in Andhra Pradesh. Here Gulf of Mannar, Tamil Nadu. Here Agastyamalai, where? In the borders of Kerala and Tamil Nadu, right? Here Nilagiri, borders of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, and here we have Ran of Kutch or Kutch, where it is in Gujarat, right? And here we have one more, the last and final one is Great Nicobar and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So these are 18 number of biosphere reserves. Among 18 number of biosphere reserves, 12 are being included or added in the list of WNBR and 6 are not included. Those are also we have defined what are the biosphere reserves not being included, and this is the exact location of the biosphere reserves. Please try to make a note of it or please try to remember, because it is very, very important in examination point of view. Thank you.